Hi, Lonnie Mackley here. I just want to talk to you today about something that affects most of our lives, and that's passing the Judas test. And what I mean by that is, you know, most of us are familiar with Judas Iscariot in the Bible, who betrayed Jesus. And most of us have a Judas in our life too, and plus we've been a Judas in somebody else's lives. And you know, today you may be carrying what a Judas did to you in your life, in your heart, and it's poison to your heart. And so in order to pass the test, so to speak, and to learn to forgive your Judas and to move on with your life without letting this poison your heart and your life is very important. And you know, most of us know the story how Judas with Jesus, you know, he walked with Jesus. He was somebody that was one of the 12 disciples and somebody that was supposed to be a trusted member of the disciples, but he turned out to be a traitor. He was somebody that was holding all of their money, and but yet he was helping himself to it, and he was acting like he was Jesus' friend to his face. But as soon as, you know, Judas didn't get what he wanted, he ran to Jesus' enemies and wanted to make a deal with him. And you may have had somebody in your life, and you know, the funny thing is Jesus picked him as a disciple, knowing that, you know, someday this person would betray him. And there's some of us that have had people in our life that God has called us to walk with, and God knew beforehand that these people would someday betray us. And like I said, some of us have been a Judas in somebody else's life, where we've, you know, been called to walk with them for a period of time in their life, but for whatever reason, because the grace either wore off or because things changed, you know, we betrayed them, or we did a revenge betrayal. You know, they betrayed us, so we betrayed them, or they said something about us, so we aired out all their dirty laundry because they air out all of ours. And it can become this horrible mess of bitterness and resentment and strife, and this terrible thing that really can cause somebody to kind of crawl back into their shell, to not trust people anymore, to not trust God anymore. And so learning how to manage your Judas, so to speak, or how to manage what you've done as a Judas to somebody is very critical. And like Jesus said, you know, he said to pray for your enemies and those who, you know, do terrible things to you. But that's not always very easy to do when you've trusted somebody, when you've let them into your inner circle, so to speak, like Judas was part of Jesus' inner circle. And you know, you can get really paranoid once you've had a Judas really do a number on you, and where you don't trust people anymore. And a lot of times what God wants from you is he wants you, no matter what people have done to you in your life, and this goes way back to the beginning, he wants you to trust the new people that he brings into your life. He wants you to trust God through these people. In other words, maybe you've had a parent or a mentor or a leader in your life that have really hurt you, that have betrayed you, that have abused you. And so now somebody new comes into your life, and because of what somebody else did in the past, you don't trust them. Maybe you're married to a spouse, and you're kind of very distrustful of them because of what a parent did, or a past boyfriend or ex-spouse or something like that. And God doesn't want you kind of dumping that junk on the new person and distrusting them, or making them, or punishing them and making them pay for what somebody else did. He wants you to be able to forgive the first people that betrayed you, that hurt you, that abused you. And God wants you to be able to trust him through that new person that he brings into your life, that God will set limits on what they can or cannot do in your life. And he wants you to trust people above what you feel that they are capable of doing to you. And you know what? A lot of people did Jesus dirty, like Judas. There was other people. But Jesus had to trust his Father beyond and above whatever man could or couldn't do here. Jesus didn't have a perfect time here. You know, he had people grabbing him, trying to throw him off a cliff. He had people constantly creating trouble for him. He even had problems with his own family, you know. And so he had to learn to trust God above those things. And I'm speaking to some people right now who have had some really bad things happen, especially with your parents. And God wants you to be able to finally let go of the offenses that were done to you, and the betrayals that you feel that you've endured. And he wants you to begin to trust him above those things, because otherwise you're going to always keep people at arm's length in your life. You're not going to be able to trust people or experience the good things that God has for you through those people until you can forgive your original Judas, so to speak. And Judas has come into our life. Like I said, sometimes God calls us to walk with them, knowing they're going to do us dirty somewhere down the line. And when your Judas does you dirty, you know, maybe it's because you didn't give them something they wanted, or you didn't let them control you, or for whatever reasons, your Judas is going to betray you. They're going to give you a kiss on the cheek, you know, when they're around you, but they're going to give you a stab in the back as soon as they turn their back on you. And it's going to hurt you a lot, because normally our Judases are people that we're very close to. They're people we've shared a lot of personal things with. And when the falling out happens, they run, they tell everybody your dirty secrets and, you know, they're all your dirty laundry and all of these horrible personal things that just, you just feel so betrayed, and it makes you so furious and angry to the point of murder sometimes, where you want to just murder them. And but God wants you to be able to begin to pray for that person, and when you start praying for them, you may just want to pray revenge on them. Oh God, judge this person, you know, make them pay for what they did, make them come and apologize to me. But you know what, in time, if you pray for them enough, God will begin to change your heart towards your Judas, and He's going to begin to soften your heart, and he'll begin to talk to you about them and show you why they are the way they are, what got them to be like that. And you'll feel compassion for them. It doesn't mean that you have to let them back into your life to do you dirty again, unless God tells you to. But it just means that God wants to take the pain away in your heart that you've been carrying around toward your Judas, and He wants to heal you of that pain so that you don't have to carry that around or carry that into the new relationships that God wants to bring into your life. And because you're going to need to be able to trust God in life, you're going to be able to need to trust people in life. Satan wants to destroy that because he wants to keep you from God's blessing. He wants to keep you from the good things that God has in your life. But God wants to heal you today. So just think about whoever is the Judas in your life today, and I'm sure you can think of one or two of them right now. And I want you to just place these people in God's hands right now. Just say, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I just place, and then fill in the blank, maybe it's Jody, Susan, Bobby, Steve, whatever their names are. I place these people in your hands, and I ask that you would help me to forgive them, to forgive what they did to me. And I ask, Father, that you'd heal me from the terrible pain that I feel in my heart concerning what they did to me. And also, after you've prayed this, pray and ask God to forgive you for the times that you've been a Judas in people's lives. And, you know, we don't realize how we can be a Judas in somebody's life. When you're gossiping about somebody behind their back and saying things, you're being a Judas. Or when you're doing things that are hurting them, that are taking things from them, manipulating them, controlling them, you're betraying them in a sense. You're taking something from them that's not yours. And so ask the Lord to show you who you've been a Judas to, and, you know, usually there is somebody down the line that you've, you know, been a Judas. You backstabbed them. You know, they trusted you. There was something you wanted from them, or you were mad at them. It's like the original Judas. He was mad because, you know, Jesus wouldn't sell this expensive perfume so that he could get the money and steal from the bag. So what does he do? He runs to his enemies and he betrays him. Sometimes, you know, we want something from somebody, or sometimes they want something from us and we don't give it to them. And so they betray us. They backstab us. And so you've got to be able to turn this around. You've got to be able to trust God. And understand, too, that you're a sinner, that you've sinned. God has forgiven you. It says in the Bible, if you're not willing to forgive others, God can't forgive you. So it's time to forgive your Judas. It's time to repent of you being a Judas. If you're the Judas, maybe, you know, if God tells you to, you need to go back and you need to apologize to a few people that you betrayed in your life. And mean it. You know, don't just give them some little, you know, careless flip kind of half apology. Let God just really convict you where you're sorry for it. And if they receive it, if they don't receive it, that's in God's hands. But you do what you're supposed to do. Be a faithful person. Be a loyal person. Be somebody that God and people can trust. And be willing to trust again after you've been hurt, because God wants to bring good new things into your life, good new people into your life. So let God heal you and pass the Judas test. Okay, my friend? Bye-bye.